If you're working inside of Airtable interfaces, there's a chance that you might be missing out on one of the best features of an interface. I'm talking about buttons inside of Airtable interfaces. Buttons are very powerful, allowing you to take many different actions, but some of the features are kind of hidden. So if you don't know to look for them, you don't know they're there. This is exactly what we're unpacking in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of the no-code tools in your arsenal. And one of our favorite no-code tools is Airtable. We're going to be breaking down Airtable buttons inside of an interface in this video. But before we get to it, I first want to invite you to join me for some bonus training. If you like what you learn here and you want to go further, make sure that you know the core features that Airtable offers. Grab our free Airtable crash course. You can sign up at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. I'll be sure to include links wherever you found this video. All right, without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of things. If this is your first time here, you'll be excited to learn, maybe, that we always start with the back end. We are always looking at the data schema before we ever go into the features. That way we have an understanding of what data, what information we're looking at. So to start, I'm in my database in Airtable, and I have two different tables. You can see projects and tasks. I just have a few example projects with a few status labeled. And of course, these projects are linked to tasks. Back here on the task side of things, we've got tasks. They are connected to a project. There is a due date for a task with a couple of different status, right? In process, waiting review, whatever. Now, the data structure does not matter all that much for what we're going to be diving into, but I like to make sure that we have an understanding of what that data looks like before we hop in. So now let's get into the actual interface itself, and we're gonna really unpack buttons. Now, the type of interface I've chosen here is one of the record review interfaces. It's certainly not the only interface type that you can choose. So when you build your first interface, you're gonna have an interface here, and this is like a folder that's gonna contain multiple pages. And you can add pages to this folder. And so we're just adding a page. And the one I've selected is the record review. You can use any of the other different layouts. They're going to work similarly to this. But the record review, given that it's one of the newer layout types, it's pretty classy and snappy. And I just like it. So I'm going to use it for this example. So here we are inside of our new interface page. And you'll see that I already have a button here. And by default, the button says go to website. Now, there's a bunch of different places that we can add buttons to. In order to add a button anywhere in here, we need to just click inside of that element first. And then on the right-hand side, right now we're in the entire record. This is kind of like the highest level of this particular page. Of course, we can select different records over here on the left, but the element here is the entire record. And you can tell that we're clicked in there because number one, we've got this blue outline around the entire section. And number two, if we look up here on the toolbar on the side, it says record. So that's what we've clicked into, and we can add a button. If we add a button, we're given the option add button action. And when we do this, it's just gonna create a button right here. But here's the part where things are a little hidden. This is where a lot of folks stop. They don't realize that when you click that button in and you enter it somewhere in your interface, go to website is not your only option. I was actually speaking with some folks the other day who didn't realize this at all, which prompted this very video. You can now, inside of this button, you're not just limited to this. I can click right here and go to the properties of the button. So with one more simple click, now you'll notice that we're inside of the record, but more specifically inside of the button element that we just created. And so we can see this again up at the toolbar, up at the top right here, but we can also tell again by looking at what's highlighted with that blue little rectangle. So here it is, it's around the go to website symbol right here around our button. We know we're in that element. And here's where we can change the action of the button. By default, as you see, it says go to external URL. So I can put a URL here, a static URL, and every time somebody pushes this button, it's gonna open up that particular URL. So in this case, it could be Airtable, or I could make it my own website, gapconsulting.io. And once we have an actual website in here, we can then also change the color. You can see the color charcoal showing up currently, but I can change this around and make it look however I would like within some reason in my app, right? So once we've selected the color and the destination, you know, we're good to go. But this is not your only limitation when it comes to buttons. We can change this action and therefore do so much more with the button. So here we have the option to update a record. Let's select this and take a look at what happens here. So when we make this selection, it's asking us, well, what are we updating? And so there has to be a way that we've selected a record to update. So in this particular case, we are inside of our projects, right? We've selected a project and we're looking at a detail of the project here. And so if we were to do the update record, we have the option to update this project. So whatever project we've selected, in this case, project one, if we went with this option and we push the button, we're updating project one. And then it's going to ask us, well, okay, what do we want to do when we push that button? Like, what exactly are we updating? So we can click here and add an action to update. So maybe, for example, we want to set a different status. So when somebody pushes that button, we're automatically assigning the status stage three. That's an example. Now that status single select field, the status of stage three, that lives in the project record. This is not the status that lives in the task record. Again, we can only update the record that we've selected here, in this case, projects. So now if we went with this, we can also assign a color before and a color after. So when we push it and we update that status, what's going to happen? So it's going to go from gray to green in this case, and the label will change after we've pushed it to say, well, this has been updated. And we can also show a check icon. Now, if you're on the business plan, the $45-ish dollars per month, then you can get this advanced functionality of making this button conditionally visible to your users. So if they are following, you know, certain conditions, maybe they're managers or something like that, you can apply certain rules to only show the button for specific users inside of your Airtable interface. All right, so this is great. We can update a record. We can automatically take immediate action to update specific things inside of the record. And this can be really helpful for moving things through a process. But obviously, we have a lot more actions here. We can copy link to the record. So if we make this choice, we are able to say, well, we're going to copy the link for this particular record when we push the button. And so for this, we're going to copy the link to this unique project, because again, we're saying, hey, we're inside of our projects. And so whatever project we've selected, when we click this button, that is going to copy the link for that particular project. And if we paste that somewhere else, or we share it in an email, whoever opens that up, assuming they have access to the data, is going to be able to access this record specifically. Diving into more actions, we can also then delete a record. This is pretty straightforward, but here we go. We're saying, hey, again, at the project level, when you push this button, get rid of it. What else? We can apply a template. This one is really, really valuable. If you've set up a template inside of Airtable, that is something that you do over and over again. So inside of our templates here, you'll see that we don't have any. We would need to go inside of record templates to start before we could ever set up this button. If you're not sure how to set up a record template, check out the videos we've done on that in the past. You can also go back to your data source here, click in the upper right corner on tools, and you've got your record templates right here. So this allows you to, with the push of a button, create additional records from a template. This is really, really helpful, especially if you have the same tasks that you run over and over again. You can just create all of those things from a simple button push inside of your interface once you get this all connected to your apply record template. And then beyond this line here, we have some more options as well. We can go to a specific interface page. So this is helpful if you have a bunch of different interface pages. Remember how we have just the one right now, it's untitled. But if we added a bunch of extra ones, we could choose these other interface pages. And with the button push, just open up that other interface page rather than having to go over to the left side of the screen and navigating to that interface. Instead, simple button push gets us there. Very nice for some quick navigation. But we can also go to an external URL. This is the default setting for this, and also go to a URL in a record. This action is really helpful if you're storing websites inside of your records, or if you want to go to a specific interface page on behalf of a record. By that, I mean, imagine that you wanted to open up an interface page similar to this one, but you wanted to go to a specific record being selected. Like maybe I want to click on the button and go right to project 3. Well, in this case, we can actually write a more complicated formula inside of Airtable. And provided that the output of that formula is a URL, we can map it here so that when we push the button, it opens up an interface page, but also to a specific record. This is a little more advanced, but it's a taste of what is possible when you really kind of ramp up to full Airtable power. And then lastly, our final action option here is to run an automation. This, of course, is going to leverage Airtable's automations that exist right inside the software. If I make this selection here, you'll notice that we don't have any automations. This is just an example database, but we can click here to create an automation, give it a name, and continue. It's going to open up the automation panel now. And this is back in our data here. You'll see this is just our second tab over. And now we've said, hey, when that button is clicked, we can set up some very specific actions to be taken. So if you did not already know all of the amazing things that buttons can do in Airtable interfaces, now you do. I hope you got a ton of value from this video and it helps you streamline your workflows even more. If you like this video, please be sure to give us a thumbs up. And any questions you have, swing on by our website. We are happy to help. That's it for this one. In the meantime, keep on building.